Thanks to 8 years of Obama and his cop-hating antics, we now have an epidemic plaguing this country as thugs continue to take out their misguided rage on our police officers. Now another shooting has taken place, this time in Yell County, Arkansas, where 3 people are now confirmed dead, including 1 police officer. The shooter is not quite done inflicting massive chaos and destruction upon the tiny town, however, as authorities are now confirming that he has taken 2 hostages as more emergency personnel flood to the scene to try and contain the situation. Lieutenant Mainhart was en route to answer a disturbance Thursday afternoon when he stopped a car for a traffic violation. At that traffic stop, an unnamed person then brandished their weapon, fatally wounding Mainhart before fleeing the area. Deputies immediately arrived to the scene to find 2 additional people murdered. They were able to track the suspect to a nearby building, where local news is reporting that the suspect is now holding 2 hostages. Right now the area is on lockdown as law enforcement swarms the area, although the exact location of the building, suspect, and hostages has yet to be released to the public. This story is developing and we will keep you updated as we keep you updated as more news becomes available. Sadly, this type of incident is becoming more and more prevalent in America as our police forces are the targets of vicious and deadly threats on a daily basis. Last year was an incredibly fatal year for our police, where CNN reported that 64 officers were killed in the line of duty. CNN reported, at least 64 law enforcement officers have been shot and killed this year, the most in 5 years, according to the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Fund. The 2016 shootings have spanned the nation, from California to Massachusetts. They've exceeded the annual average of police shooting deaths over the past 10 years, 53. And this year's total is higher than the number of firearms-related police deaths in 2015. According to the fund, firearms were responsible for 41 of 123 officer fatalities in 2015, one of the safest years for officers on record. The decade's highest total came in 2011, with 73 officers shot dead. This year's shooting deaths include an officer on her first day on the job and a sheriff's corporal who was about to retire. The most recent shootings happened in Americus, Georgia. An officer from Georgia Southwestern State University and a city officer were fatally shot as they checked a report of a domestic dispute at an apartment complex near the school, police said. The total of 64 includes 2 incidents in which an officer was accidentally shot by another officer. Sadly, things don't seem to be improving much as Fox News reports that police officer deaths are on the rise this year by a startling 10% from last year. They reported, the shooting death of a deputy constable in Texas this week added to the rise in U.S. law officers killed in the line of duty in 2017, 34 so far this year, a jump of 10% from 2016. Still, gun-related deaths are down almost 40%, according to the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Fund. The statistics show a 27% increase in traffic-related police deaths but a 38% decrease in firearms-related deaths. WI Boy donates Nintendo Wii to police after officer killed. In addition, there has been a 150% increase in other causes of death, some of which are aircraft crashes, drowning, electrocution, falling, fire-related incidents, and job-related illness and poisoning. The Memorial Fund reported 135 law enforcement officers were killed last year. 64 deaths involved firearms, and 14 of those involved domestic incidents. The most recent death this year was Assistant Chief Deputy Constable Clint Greenwood, a 30-year veteran to the Harris County Constable's Office, Fox 26 reported. Oklahoma police officer killed. Details on suspect emerge. Greenwood was shot at least once in the neck near a courthouse on Monday morning. Despite his gunshot wound, he was still able to radio for help, saying, "I'm bleeding out," according to KTRK. The attacker escaped, prompting a massive manhunt. The suspect was still at large Tuesday. Greenwood was given aid at the scene and was eventually flown to a Houston hospital where doctors pronounced him dead. Clint was absolutely a target, for whatever reason. "We don't know," Montgomery County Sheriff's Lieutenant Tim Cannon said. "But he didn't need to be a target. Clint was there to help. And whoever this person was, Clint probably would have reached out to help him as well." Greenwood was the second officer fatality in Texas this year, ranking Texas one of the 3rd highest states in police deaths, according to the National Law Enforcement Officers Memorial Fund. New York currently has the highest amount of police fatalities, with 5 officers lost. The Officer Down Memorial page states that the number of police deaths has decreased each month as the year progresses.
Please do not forget to subscribe and like and comment because we want to hear your voice, and thank you for watching.